Okay, first of all, I will welcome for the third session of floriculture. Today we will discuss regarding the carnation. I feel you all seen the carnations in the protected cultivation in your college or the in the state tour, All India tour, or in your colleges or other farmers field with respect to the cultivation, right? I feel everyone has seen the carnation. Okay, the scientific name will be Dianthus caryophyllus. The family is Caryophyllus. The common name, usually the multiple choice questions, they will ask the common name. The divine flower, clopink, gilly flower, these are the common names. Then coming to the introduction, carnation are perhaps one of the most popular flowers after the rose. Okay. Then carnation are also commonly referred by their scientific name, Dianthus. This is also the common name of the carnation. The dios means the god, juice, and anthos means flower. This is also called as flower of God. This is native to Mediterranean region. Then coming to the uses, it is one of the important cut flower. It is in both in domestic and international market. Then used as a bedded, used for the bedding, pot plant, rock gardens, window basket, and edging. This is unique with respect to the softness, in creating the softness in the rock gardens. This is popular in the flower arrangement also. This is mainly cultivated in the European countries. In India, we will cultivate in the cooler regions like Bangalore, Pune, Delhi, Trivandrum. Then this flower also have the medicinal value. These are all the ways how the carnation is used. This is called buttonnary. You should remember the buttonnary. This terminology is referred for the single flower which is decorated in the decorated for the men. Okay, the single flower with a small leaf which is usually pinned for the pocket. This is buttonnary. And the corsage will be used for the women. This also you should remember. Then the flower consists of pistil. This is the stigmatic surface. Then this is the anther, stamens. These are all the petals, corals. This is hermaphrodite flower. This female part and male part, both are present in the single flower. It is termed as hermaphrodites. Then coming to the types and varieties. We'll see the species. In the Dianthus, Dianthus caryophyllus is the commercial species. And other than that, we'll also use the Dianthus barbatus and Dianthus sinensis. These are all the three important species mainly commercially exploited. Then these are the three main types of the garden carnation. This is border carnation. Then this is perpetual flowering carnation. Then coming to the standard types and spray type. Standard means this type produces only the single large bloom on the large flower stack, and this suffers the diseases when grown in the warm. You just remember, standard means the single large bloom on a long flower stalk. Sprays means produces many flowers on the smaller size. This is termed as sprays. Then varieties in the standard, Monaco, Regino, these are all the sim series are very important in the carnation with respect to the standards. Then spray type, these are all some of the varieties. Don't need to mug up all these varieties. I'll just brief out which are all the important one. Then these are all the commercially cultivated pink dona. These will ask in the multiple type questions. Liberty is also very important. Then cultivar resistant to diseases. This is very important because the major problem in the cultivation of carnation is Fusarium wilt. The wilt is the major problem. The resistant varieties were Angele, Regina, and the tolerant varieties were Salome, Vanya, and highly susceptible. This is also very important. Pungi. And for the blight and the rust, this is not that much important. You remember the Fusarium wilt resistant varieties. With respect to the production technology of the carnation, first we will prepare the soil or the land. Then we will go for the soil fumigation. Then we will prepare the beds. Then we'll plant the cuttings or the propagules. The method of planting we will explain in the next slides. Then after the vegetative growth, we will go for the pinching. After the pinching, we will try the plants. This terminology is netting. After the netting, we'll go for the disbudding. This is followed in the standard types, like to get the cut flowers. Then for the commercial purpose, we'll usually go for the fertigation. Then after reaching the harvesting stage, we'll harvest, then we'll strip the flowers into the bunches, then we'll pack, and the packaging and marketing. With respect to the soil, growing media, and preparation of bed, I think you all well know with respect to pH, 6 to 8 neutral. Then EC is also very important. And the media, with respect to the media, the plants will grow well in the perlite or the rock hole with a mixture of 3:1 or 1:1. The soil mixture, 50% of sand, 30% of loam, and 20% of clay is ideal. With respect to media sterilization, the used chemicals were methyl bromide or formalin. This is the bed preparation style. Once the bed prepared, we'll go for the applying of basal fertilizer. A raised bed system is followed in the carnation to avoid the wilt problem. Fusarium is a soil-borne fungi which is major constraint in the production of carnation. This has to be noted down. Then with respect to the sterilization of beds, to avoid the soil-borne fungi or the insects, we'll usually go for the methyl bromide at 25 to 30 grams per meter square and formalin at 3 to 7%. Then basamate, this is highly efficient. Then with respect to the propagation, we have mainly the vegetative propagation is prominent. The soft terminal cutting is the most common method for the multiplication of carnation at commercial scale. This can be followed throughout the year. This is the commercial method followed in the carnation. These are all the terminal cuttings. Once they plucked the terminal cuttings, they were planted in the cocoopit. After the sprout, once they will rooted and sprouted, they will be planted in the main field. You see the rooted cuttings in the protrace. Once they are rooted, they will be transferred to main field. Then one more method is layering. Layering is mainly done in the pots or directly in the ground. This is not most common. Grafting is also not much followed, but for your reference, this is also followed in the carnation. Micropropagation is very much exploited, but not at the commercial scale, because at the lower price we will get the rooted cuttings from the terminal tips, but the micropropagation will be much costlier. That's why usually we go for the tip cutting. Then with respect to planting, you know how to plant, and the space, the plant density is very important. Per meter square, 30 to 45 plants will accommodate. This is the method two row method or the four row method is followed. Two lateral, beside that we'll plant the two rows of carnation. You see here, this netting is initially applied. After that, the planting is going to done. Irrigation should be done regularly. This supporting is very much essential in the carnation, because these carnations are very weak. They tend to bend. Unless we provide the proper support, they will not grow for the cut flowers. Usually the outer structure will be metallic wire and the GI pipe. Here the special practice is netting. You have to remember this netting. Netting word is associated with the carnation. This is called netting. First, they will establish the GI pipes. Then they will tie the wires. On that, they will try in the carnation plants. The netting is followed. First layer of netting at the planting time. At 7.5 into 7.5 centimeter, the mesh size will be. The second layer will be at 10 into 10 centimeter, then third layer, then fourth layer. Then support the net. The net, as we are earlier discussed, the netting is very important. With respect to the nutrient management, they won't ask the NPK level, this and that. With respect to the special cultural operation, they will ask definitely. The pinching is most common. This is referred for the breaking out of the tip of the buds to encourage the growth of side shoot. This is essential for the standards to grow the cut flowers. Then depending on the need of crop spread, we'll go for the different type of pinching. Single pinch, one and a half pinch, then double pinch. This is very, very much important. Single pinch means the ideal time for the pinching is morning. When the plant attains the 6 nodes, the first pinch is given. 5 to 7 centimeter of apical portion is pinched off. This is done to get the very good cut flowers. Then 1.5 pinch. This is after the single pinch. Once again, out of 4 to 6 lateral produced, 2 to 3 lateral shoots were once again pinched at the fourth pair of leaf. Then coming to double pinching. Double pinch, this 1.5 pinch is mainly done to get the staggered flowering. Means if you want to get the supply of carnation continuously, this single and half pinch is followed. Then come to double pinching. Double pinching means mainly this is done to delay the flowering. This terminology you have to remember. Single pinch for the quality cut blooms. 1.5 pinch, this is for staggered harvesting of flowers. Then double pinching to delay the flowering. This much is enough. You have to note down all these points. This is the pinching.
Sir, please one more time repeat.
Which one?
And that's pinching, single pinch.
I will repeat. For single pinch, you remember, this is done mainly to get the quality cut blooms. This is mainly for cut flower production. Then 1.5 pinch. This is mainly done to delay the flowering. Mainly for the staggered harvesting of flowers. 1.5 pinch is for staggered harvesting of flowers. The double pinching is mainly done to get the delayed flowering. If the market is full of carnation, then we want to delay that season, we can go for the double pinching. Then this is the single pinch. At the initial stage, they will pinch. This is done mainly in the standard carnation. This is before pinching. They will cut the apical buds. So they will get the full flush after the single pinch. Then disbudding mainly refers to removal of single buds of terminal buds to receive maximum food for the growth of single dominant bud. This is mainly done in the standards. Removal of laterals also followed. Then main flower bud is alone left. Other buds are removed. Then for the sprays, the terminal and the main buds are removed to encourage the more number of side shoots. Then this is the disbudding. Only the dominant bud will be allowed. Other will be disbudded. Then with respect to the physiological disorder, calyx splitting is major one. The cultivars with too many petals are susceptible to calyx splitting. The variation in the temperature and environmental condition also influence the calyx splitting. These are the main reason why the genetic makeup is also cause for the calyx splitting. Then the variation in the temperature and environmental condition. This much you remember. Then how to control? Select the tolerant or resistant varieties, as we earlier told. Then regulate the temperature. Then maintain the optimum fertilizer dose. If the nitrogen increases and the boron decreases, the calyx split will increase. Then use the calyx banding. This is also very important. Calyx banding. This is also reduce the. This is mainly the rubber band, 6 mm wide, clear plastic tape. This is calyx band used around the calyx of the flower, which have just opened. This is called calyx banding, mainly done for to avoid the calyx split. This is the calyx split. You see, the petals have been overgrown. That's why you can also reduce by calyx banding. This is sleepiness. You know anyone sleepiness? Usually in the carnation, what will happen? The petals tend to grow upwards and they do not open. This is mainly due to ethylene gas emitted by the fruits and vegetables when we stored in the cold storage. This can be controlled by not mixing the flowers with the fruits and vegetables during the storage and transportation. So keep the ethylene absorbent tablets in the storage or transportation time. Then due to boron deficiency also, malformed flower buds, shortened stems, excessive branching will be seen. Then curly tips will also be observed in the carnation. With respect to the major pest and disease, here also the sucking pest like aphids, thrips, then red spider mite, mainly the tetronychus will be the major problem in carnation. Here you can observe the red spider mite on the buds. The webbing of the red spider mite, you can observe. These are all microscopic insects. Then bud borer is also very important, Helicarpa. And this will destroy the whole bud of the carnation. The nematode problem is also there, but not that much level. We can control by soil sterilization using Besamil. The major disease, the Fusarium wilt. Then stem rot, Rhizoctonia stem rot, then Alternaria leaf spot, then rust, bacterial wilt, then gray mold also there. Fusarium wilt is the major. The affected plant show the foliage wilting, then rotting of the stem below the ground. This is soil-borne disease. Rotting of the stem, the affected plants will rot. How to control this? Drench the soil fungicides like Benomil, Ridomil, and this biological control measure is very much important. Bacillus, Streptomyces, Trichoderma, Pseudomonas. You please note this. Note on this. Then coming to the black spot. This is also very important, caused by Alternaria. Alternaria dianthe. Botrytis is also major one, but not that much compared to Fusarium. Then Phytophthora is also a soil-borne disease in carnation. Then coming to the harvesting and yield. For the standards, after the 3 to 5 months of period, we'll usually harvest at the paintbrush stage. You have to remember this terminology. Paintbrush stage is the half-opened flowers. Is the stage to harvest the standard cultivars of carnation. Tight bud stage or the paint bud stage. For the sprays, at least 2 to 3 flowers opened. After that, we will go for the harvesting of sprays. Yield is not that much important. they won't ask the yield. Mainly three stage of harvest will be done based on the type of demand. Tight bud stage, it is advised for the long term distance marketing. At the you remember tight bud stage for long distance marketing. Paint brush stage, this is for mainly what? Standard carnation.
Standard.
Yes. Then semi open, this is ideally for short distance marketing. Like that, you remember in the carnation, tight bud stage for the long distance. Paint brush stage for the standard one. Semi open stage, this is ideal for short distance. Like this, you have to remember the concepts. Then they won't ask the grades also. Coming to the preservatives, usually 8 HQC or 8 HQS is used in the preservative as a preservative solution. Then silver thiosulfate is also used. Then cytokine is used. Then the sugar, citric acid. This is the ideal preservative solution used for the any cut flowers. They won't ask the numericals, but they will ask the numericals when for the what is the preservative solution for the rose or carnation. At what concentration the sugar is used in the sugar is used as a preservative in the carnation at 0.5 to 2%. This much you have to remember. Then this is the grading, then packaging in the bunches. Then after the bunching, they will wrap. Why this is very much, this is also very important. Why this is more suited for the expert? Because it is very light in weight. So this is very essential criteria for exporting of any flower or any horticulture or agriculture product. This is very much light. And also one more good quality is it will rehydrate very quickly. Means it will regain the moisture when we dip in the preservative solutions. This is the layout, how the bed will prepare. Mainly in the South Indian condition, the naturally ventilated polyhouse will be used for the cultivation. These are the sim varieties or the standard cultivars will be referred for the carnation only. If the sim comes, these are related to carnation. Sim series is referred for which of the following crops? They will ask like that. Spray means multiple flowers. Then this is very much important for the cultivation of carnation. The day temperature should be 20 to 25 degree and night temperature should not fall less than 10 degrees Celsius. If the temperature difference between the night and day increases or fluctuates, what will happen?
Calyx splitting.
Yes, sure. Calyx splitting will happen. So we have to maintain the temperature in the greenhouse. Then we have to give the 30 to 50% of shade inside the greenhouse. The humidity should be maintained ideal, 50 to 60%. Then you see here, the fluctuation in the day and night temperature results in the calyx splitting and malformation of flowers. This has to be maintained. This is the major problem in the carnation. This will be the definite question. With respect to the propagation, we have earlier discussed. This is the tip cuttings. This is the commercially followed method. The planting should be done to depth to avoid the stem rotting. Planting should not be done. Why? To avoid the stem rotting, because this carnation is highly susceptible to soil borne fungi like Fusarium and Rhizoctonia. This is very, very much important. You should remember this. Fusarium and Rhizoctonia is the stem rotting causing fungi in carnation. So we should avoid the deep planting. Then this is the netting process. This is the first stage before planting. Then after planting, 12 centimeter. You see here, first stage, second stage, third stage, and fourth stage. This is netting, supporting of carnation. This is very tender and weak. Carnation is. This is the fertigation system followed in the highly high tech or automatic controlled polyosis. Pinching, you observe here. After 21 days after the planting, they will pinch the top leaves to by retaining the top four to six pair of leaves. This is the first pinching. Then this is the single pinch, you observe here. This is the first single pinch. Then this is single and half pinch. Here you see, this is the first pinch. They got the lateral shoots. After that, they pinched once again. Why? Because to get the staggered flowering, continuous flowering, they will do this. Then double pinching. All the laterals were pinched back to only four pair of leaves. The flowering will be delayed in this process. Okay. After the first pinch, the lateral will appear. Then after that also, they will go for the pinching. So the flowering will be delayed. This is the disbudding. You have to remember this. The Society of American Florists, they will give the standards of the carnation, like blue, red, green. You should remember this corrugated box size. This is unique for the carnation. Usually they won't ask, but sometimes they will ask in depth also. 122 is the length, then 50 centimeter is the breadth, then 30 centimeter is the height. This is the standard size box for the carnation flower packaging. Then usually pre-cooled at the 0 degree Celsius. This is also very important. Pre-cooling temperature of carnation, 0 degree Celsius. Then coming to some of the important pests, I'll show you some photos so that you'll grasp more. The major pest will be sucking pest, as I told you. Thrips, mites. Then bud borer is also very important. Thrips. This is mite. Two spotted spider mite is very much important in carnation. This is the major. Tetronychus. You remember the host also. Rose, carnation, gerbera, chrysanthemum, tomato. These are all the host. This mite will affect all these crops. You know the damaging symptom, how they will infect the plants. They won't ask the symptom usually, but if they ask, the stunted growth, drying of the plants are the symptoms of which among the following insect pest. Like that, they will ask. Biology also, they won't ask. This is the microscopic view of mites colony. These are all the eggs, nymphs, and this one is adult. This is the microscopic view. Adult mite. Eggs. These are eggs. These are the eggs of two spotted spider mite. This is very much important. Two spotted. You can observe the two spot. They will live beneath the leaves. Management. How? If they were severely affected, cut and burn. Otherwise, give the water spray. They will wash away. Then use the pongamia oil. This is also very much important. Then use the acaricides like Vertimac. You remember this? Acaricides. Then thrips also very much common. Franklina. This species will only appear in the greenhouse condition. Franklina. They may give the different species of thrips. Which among the following is the greenhouse thrips? They will ask. You please note it down. frankly. Host distribution. You remember, this is a polyphagous species, means it will attack and damage the multiple crops like tomato, lettuce, chili, cucumber, leguminous crops, other flower crops. Then this is the thrips, thrips cycle. You have, these are the eggs of thrips. After the egg hatch, it will comes to first instar, then second instar, then comes to pupa stage, then it will go for the adult stage. You know, egg, pupa, then adult stage, right? With respect to the management, imidacloprid, acipen, these are highly effective for the management of sucking pest. With respect to bud borer, Helicorpa armigera, this is very, very much important. You remember this family name also, not today. This is commonly asked. This is the damaging shift. The larva will feed the flower buds, so it will directly affect the marketing produce. Then how to manage? Hand picking. Then remove and destroy the larvas. Then use the yellow sticky traps. This is also very important. For the monitoring, use yellow sticky traps. 15 numbers per hectare. This is very important. Then aphids, mysis persicae. You all know symptoms, how to control them. This is the egg stage, nymph stage, and adult stage. I'll take one more class with respect to the entomology or with respect to the insect development. They will ask the different stages of insects also, different terminologies. This is very much important. Predators of this aphids are sucking pest, mainly coccinellids, syrphids, chrysoprole. These are all natural predators of this sucking pest, aphid. In the carnation also, they will extract the essential oil. These three are important species, major species. Types of carnation they won't ask, just remember. I think we discussed this PPT. Okay, fine then. I will show you one video regarding this. These are all the possible ways. This is the first stage. Fully grown crop. This is how the bunching is done. Only in the cooler part, this crop will grow. That too in the protected cultivation. This is the major problem. This is the soil sterilization, first process. This is bassamide. See the planting material. Deleafing. This is also very important. Deleafing. You are listening, right?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Okay. You tell me where exactly the carnation has been origin, the origin of this carnation.
Sir, southern France origin.
Yes, the Mediterranean region or the southern France. Usually they won't give the country name. The Mediterranean region will be the best suitable option. Then you tell me the temperature requirement. Temperature requirement, requirement of this carnation. Carbon dioxide requirement we have discussed in the rose. For rose we need 1000 to 3000 ppm, but for the carnation we need 500 to 1500 ppm CO2 concentration. If you give more CO2, the more photosynthesis will be there and more vegetative growth will be there, so the yield will be increased. But if it exceeds the optimum limit, it will cause the toxicity for the plants. Mainly it is propagated through seeds. The propagation methods includes seeds, terminal stem cuttings, then micropropagation. Seeds is mainly done in the breeding program. The terminal cuttings usually 8 to 10 centimeters long, and it should contain 4 to 6 pairs of leaves. Okay. Then you understand the single pinch. Pinching you understood, right?
Yes.
Yes, sir.
Okay. Then you have to remember the weedy sites. Pre-emergent, post-emergent. You have to remember the which are all the pre-emergent, post-emergent weedicides. Okay, we'll discuss that. You tell me that the ideal pulse solution for the carnation, as we just discussed, right? Silver thiosulfate, then one cytokinin, then sucrose, right? Then important diseases you should remember. Fusarium is very important. Then rhizoctonia is very important. Then phytophthora rot is very important. Then alternaria, this is flower blight. Then bacterial wilt is also important. Then fairy ring spot, this is also important. Major pest, red spider mites, thrips, then helicorpa. Then here we observe the virus problem also. Carnation, necrotic, flex virus, then mottle virus, vine mott. These are all transmitted through sucking pest like this aphid thrips. Then important physiological disorder, you should remember this. Calyx splitting, sleepiness, graziness, then narrow leaves, then splitting at the nodes. Right? You tell me the causes of calyx splitting and how it could be controlled. We just now discussed.
So temperature fluctuations and the environmental conditions.
Yes,
some of the environmental conditions. The
fluctuation of temperature, then night temperature should not fall less than 10 degrees Celsius. And if we give more nitrogen also, it will cause. Then it is maybe due to genetic factor. Then with cultivars and the varieties, hybrids, it will differ. Then we should do the banding, calyx banding. Then, you know, greasiness, in carnation greasiness is also very important. This is mainly due to no flower will be produced in this condition, physiological. This is also associated with the genetic related disorder. This also vary from cultivar to cultivar. We have to remove and destroy such plants. This is the only way to control the greasiness. You should remember, greasiness is the physiological disorder associated with the carnation. Okay. And with respect to sleepiness, this is a temporary or permanent.
As a temporary.
Okay, temporary. This is mainly due to ethylene. This can be controlled using the ethylene absorbents. Then with respect to splitting of nodes, mainly due to boron deficiency. It can be rectified through application of boron. You just remember splitting of nodes, then calyx splitting also very important. Then tinting of carnation, anyone can explain?
Sir, tinting means when we keep the cut flowers in white cut flowers in a vase and provide them any color, they will absorb that color and those white flower will become colored.
Yes, the different patterns we can observe in the white colored carnation. This is very much important. You should note it down. Tinting is associated with a carnation flower, white carnation flowers. Okay. Then some of the important recently released variety of IHR, Arka Flame, Arka Tejas. You should remember. IHR and IRI varieties, you should remember. Dios means God, Anthos means flower. Okay, the national flower of Spain is? Yes, the national flower of Spain is carnation only. We are dealing with the carnation, that's why the answer will be carnation. This is quantitatively long day plant. This has to be noted down. This is very much important. Quantitatively long day plant. Okay. Then staking, disbudding, pinching. These are all terminologies related to carnation. Then sim series will be associated with the carnation. Then this perpetual, Margaret, Malmaison, Royal. These are all the different types. They won't ask this many depth questions. But you should remember the pinching, different pinching types and why they are important. Then tinting also very important. But you should remember the causes of calyx splitting, how they can be controlled. Moon dust series. This is very important. You note it down. Moon dust series. These are all genetically modified varieties of hybrids of carnation. Moon dust series. Okay. Sleepiness is the post-harvest or pre-harvest physiological disorder?
Post-harvest.
Only it will comes in the post-harvest when we store with the fruits or vegetable or ethylene-rich environment, the sleepiness will be observed. Okay. Then anything else? You should ask the questions, doubts regarding this. This is enough with respect to the carnation. Yes, Ankita, Anuj, Euphoria, Gayatri, Namrata. Is this okay?
Yes. Yes, sir.
Okay, then fine. Okay, for today class, this is enough. We'll discuss another topic tomorrow. Till then, take care. Okay. Can we close the meeting now?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Okay, then. Okay.
Thank you, sir.
Okay. Bye-bye.